Hi guys, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. In our last class, we saw how to add the brand and how to view the brand. In this class, I am going to teach the product, how to add the products and how to view the products. Right. Now let's go to the lessons. So here, go to the RS folder. These are the files I have created in layout folder. These are the files for created in the Java folder. Now what I'm going to do is go to the app folder, right click, new activity. Here we have to select as empty activity. Here we have to write as a product. This one should be product. Click finish. Now your product activity created successfully. Right. Now what I am going to do is here go to the layout folder, select the product.xml. Here I am going to change it as the same thing like that. This one should be linear layout, orientation vertical. Here we have to change it as a gravity. Make it as center. Right. Now I no need to design again. I have already designed the category part, so go to the category part. This is the layout. Just we have to copy the one, all that of you have to copy right here. Inside this layout you have we put another layout. You have to copy the inside the all the layouts, and you have to paste on the, go to the activity product.xml. You have to paste inside this layout here. Right. Perfect. Now go to the design. It is look like a category. We have to change it as a product here. So go to the text. This should be the heading. This one should be product at product. This one should be text product. Product. After that, this one ID we have to change. This is a product. This ID should be product. First one should be product. Second ID should be product. This me description. This one should be product description. Right. Perfect. After that, we need to design the another. We have to write another two layouts. So here we have to write Control C to copy this layout. Control V to paste here. Here. Instead of the text view, we have to write the layout as here, this one. We have to edit text, we no need it. We have to remove this one. We have to change it as this one for category. Category. Here, we have to change it as a snipper tool. So we have to spinner. Spinner tool, we have to change it as spinner tool. Here we have to give the wrap content. We have to put wrap content. This one should be wrap content. After that, we have to write the ID we have to write as here as cat ID. Right. Snipper tool. Now here let's see go to the design. Here this is a problem. So here we have to, instead of the wrap content, we have to give the width. Width is we have to give as 250 dB. Now you can see the design. Now it's perfect. Right. Now it's perfect. Right. Simple. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to create another layout. So here we have to copy the one. Control C to copy. Control V to paste here. What is this? Okay, now let's copy this one. Control C to copy, Control V to paste below. Now here I'm going to change this one as a brand. Here also brand ID. Right, that's it. It's a brand ID. Right. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I need to do another couple of things. Quantity and price. So here we need to copy this text box and text view. Ctrl C to copy this one, and you have to paste it here. Paste two times. So you have to create the relevant here. So here we have to change it as this one should be quantity. So write as a quantity. This one price. Here also price. That's the thing we have to write. The simple layout we have to made for the product, right? Now after that, after design this one, we have to do the stuff is go to the Java folder. Here we have to select this file product here, this one. Here first I'm going to add the this one. Now here first we have to write as a edit text box, edit text. You have to write ed1 comma ed2 ed3 ed4. Right, after that we have to write the snipper. We have to write a snipper 1. You have to write a snipper 1, right? We have to create two snipper. After that we need a array list. So here array list, this has a string, data type string. Create the object as titles equal, you have to as a new array list. So you have to write as the same string, copy and paste here. That's it. Now here we have to copy this one, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. This one make it as 1. After that we have to write as array adapter. Here we have to create the object as array adapter here. After that we have to write as array adapter, the same array adapter here, copy and paste it here, change it as 1, this one. After that we have to write as a button b1, right? That's the thing we have to do, right? After that what I'm going to do is, here I'm going to these things, I'm going to equal into the relevant IDs. Okay, relevant ID mean here we have to go to the this one, we have to close it. Now here these are the relevant ID we have to set into the relevant variables. This one a product description, this one cat ID, this one, right? So here what I'm going to do is, here I'm going to go to this one. Okay, first one should be edit text, first one ed1, we have to equal into the find view by ID, r.id dot, first one should be product, second one should be ed2 dot find view by ID, r.id dot, second one should be product description. The ID is not, what is the problem? Like product description, PR, sorry. Let's change it as, go to the code, product description ID, you have to change it as a product ID, product description. Yes, right. Then we have to go here, we have to write as here, product description. Perfect. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to get the snipper tool. So third one should be the snipper tool, this one. Category and brand both are display as a snipper tool. So here write as a snipper tool object, I have already created here variable. So snipper one, snipper, right? this one you have to call it here snipper one snipper sorry not one snipper equal find view by id r dot id dot here I'm going to change it as this one as a price. ED4 mean price. Here this one. Price. Okay. Now we have set the ID for snipper tool and text tool. Text view. After that, what I'm going to do is here. I'm going to do the another stuff is button. So button B1 equal find view by ID R dot ID dot BTN. One right here what I'm going to do is first I'm going to load the category, all the category we have to load from the database to this snipper control. Okay, what are the category available, all the category we have to load here, as well as brand also we have to load the brand. User able to select the category and brand from snipper tool. So how to do the task is the product here we have to write this. First we have to go to the category table here, view category. The same code, this one, view category, we have to copy the stuff, we have to copy the all the stuff, we have to copy here, right, we have to copy from here. Ctrl C to copy this one. You have to paste it here. Now you have to change the couple of changes here. You have to make couple of changes. We don't need this one. This one we have to write category. We don't need this stuff. ID only no need. I have loaded only the category part, category only. So here we have to column only, category column only enough. Select all from category. We have to load only the category. So category column only we have to load. What are the category available? We have all the category we have loaded, and we have to set into here. Okay, so this way we have set it here. Here we have to change this one as a snipper adapter. Right, it's not list adapter, a snipper adapter. Right, now here what I'm going to do is here we have to we don't need this ID and everything, we only need the category stuff only. So the category, yeah, okay. Now here we have to, we no need this one, we have to remove the stuff, no need this one as well, we have to remove the this stuff. Right, now what I'm going to do is here I'm going to set the title here, titles dot add. Here we have to write as a c dot get string, we have to write the category, this one, right, that's the thing we have to write. The category is loaded to the snipper control. Right, now let's execute the program and check. Before I execute the program, let me make the link for that. So go to the main, this is the main page, main. Here we have to, what is the button for the main dot xml, this is the button, product button, btn3. So we have to go to the main here, btn3, you have to get the button btn3 b3 here, b3, you have to get here, find view by id r dot id dot btn3. Here we have to write as b3 dot set on click listener, new view on click listener. Right, here what I'm going to do is here intent, Ctrl C to copy this intent, you have to paste here. We have to change this one as a product class. Right, That's the stuff we have to do. Now let's execute the program and check. Right now, here I'm going to log in the stuff. Product, if you click product, scopes the product here, you will be able to see the product categories. Categories it is what display fine here. You will be able to select the one here. All the category what you enter, all the stuff is here, it will be working fine. You can check the category here. Category, these are the categories available: TV, fan, mobile. You can easily view the category. When the person enter the product, product description, select the category, you will be able to select the category, whatever you want. Okay. Now I'm going to view the brand here, the same like a category. So what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to the code here, the same code I'm going to copy here, the final, right, final cursor, this one, starting here, we have to copy from here, right? We have to copy from here. After close the this is the while loop. We have to, this is the while of ETA, the code will be end. The this is the final bracket to close. So this we have to copy, right? Copy and Control C to copy, Control V to paste after this bracket, right? Now the cursor object I already created C above for category. This one for brand we have to create B. So B here, also B, this one should be brand. We have to create a brand, select all from brand. This one should be brand, column brand. This select all from brand. I'm selecting the all the data from the brand table. Brand table only, particularly I'm going to get the column only for this column, brand column only. I am going to display what is the records available the brand. We have to display here, so we have to give here. After that we have to set the titles here. Put title 1, this one title 1, we already create the object above title 1. This one for category, this one for brand, title 1, right? Title 1, sniper 1, sniper 1 mean this one. This is a brand ID, sniper 1. So brand is sniper 1. Here also adapter also we have to change it as this one. One mean here I have create two adapter, this for category, this adapter for brand. This title for category, this title for brand, right? I have to create it, right? Now here what I am going to do is here I am going to load the final array from which one, brand. This one for brand for here. If you double click on, these are the properties on the brand. Let's select this one, should be brand. Select as this one, we have to create the object as brand. Here what I'm going to do is here we have to change the class here, brand here. You have to create the object as BA. So here BA dot brand equal, you have to call the brand here. That's the thing we have to do. So here this one, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one we have to add the brand, this one Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be title 1. We have to call this brand. That's the stuff we have to do. Here adapter 1, this one adapter 1, sorry, adapter 1, this one B. We have to change the brand B. That's the thing we have to do. Now let's check whether it's working fine or not. Here we have to change this one B, this one also B, right? Carefully we have to change the thing as C as B. Okay, we have to, C mean category, B mean C, B mean brand. Okay, now let's check whether it's working fine or not, right? Perfect. Now here John 123 product, but it's error. error is here, but the error b dot get string brand. Here the problem is, what is the problem is here, we don't have a problem on this line. The problem is here, you have to if c move first, you have to write this here, c you have to change it as b, then we have to execute the program and check. Now here we have to go to the app chown 123 product. Now here it will be successfully display the things. Here we'll be able to display the things, right? Perfect, perfectly done. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to if I fill this form and click add button, it is a record should be added into the database table. So let's do the task. So here what I'm going to do is here, after that, this is the button, we have to get the ID b1. So here we have to write as a b1 dot set on click listener, new view on click listener. Here we have to write as instead of writing like this, we have to write a separate function. So we have to write the separate function here below, separate function below here, right here. We no need to write, go to the category, we already there, we have to return the function here, category, that right, same function, you have to control C to copy, control C to copy this function, we have to come to the brand. So here we have to paste it, right. Now here what I'm going to do is, we have to change the stuff. This one should be product ED1, this is a product description, ED2, right. After that, we need another two columns, that should be category, another one should be brand. So here we have to write as a sniper dot, you have to write dot get selected item dot to string. This one we have to write as a sniper one dot get selected item dot to string. After that, what I am going to do is here, this one control C to copy, control V to paste here, this one 3, this one 4, this one quantity, this one price. Right, that's what we have to do here, this one quantity, this one price. So you have to equal into the relevant variables like this. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to insert the data. So we have to write as, this one should be product int id integer primary key auto increment. Here we have to write as a product, this one should be product, this one should be product description, comma, copy, control C to copy, control V to paste here, this one should be cat id category, we have to write as a category, this one should be brand, comma, you have to write as control C to copy, control V to paste here. So we have to write as a category, this one should be brand, this one should be quantity, this one should be price. These are the columns we have to create at into the database table. ID, product, ID with auto increment, product description, data type should be varchar, category, brand, quantity, price. Okay, you have to create this table carefully. Product table, which name is product. Here we have to write as a product. Insert product. You have to write as a, not take the ID, it will be auto incremented. How many question mark we needed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 we needed. So we have to write 6, 3, 4, 5, 6 we need 6 question mark. Right, perfect. Now here we have to set into the relevant variable. So Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here this one. So here what I'm going to do is, here second one should be, first one should be this product, second one should be product description, third one should be category, fourth one should be brand, this one on the fifth, final one should be price. Right, simple. After that we have to write as a product created. Product created. Right, after created we have to clear the text boxes. So so we have to, no need, we have just create the text boxes only. ED3, ED4, focus on the request. Now let's do the all the stuff. You have to check once time is all the correct. Product, product description, category, brand. Right here, okay, perfect. Now let's do the task. Right now here, this variable, this object, function, sorry, we have to call into the this button, b1 button. Right, that's the task you have to. Now let's execute the program. Now here, John, 1, 2, 3, product. Here I'm going to add the product as LG001. Here we have write LG only, something like that. You have write like this. You have write the category as TV, brand as LG, quantity we have to 100 quantity, let's say 100 quantity, price should be 12,000. Click add button. Category failed. Why? Sorry, category, no, category failed. Not a category fail, the record added fail. Sorry, category failed here. Product category fail. Why? What's the problem? Go to the run and check. 6 values for 2 columns. Right, the problem is here, we haven't set the tables here, table name here. Right, what are the tables names available? So first one should be product, second one should be product description, third one should be category, fourth one should be brand, after that quantity, price. We have to set the column names properly. Here these are the columns names, you have to set it the properly. Right, now let's execute it. Here these relevant column we have to assign the questions mark here. This question, these records are coming here, it goes here. Product should be go first question mark, product description goes to second question mark, likewise it's adding. Right, if you call this function, record is added. Now let's check it. Here 1, 2, 3, click login, click product, Now here I'm going to write as a LG product, LG some you can write the product description. Now you have select the TV category, TV brand I'm going to select as LG, quantity I'm going to 100, price 12,000. Now here click add button, product created. Now the product is created successfully, right? Perfect. Now after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to view the product records into the database. After add the records, after that I'm going to view the records to the products view. Okay, if you click this product view button, you will be able to view the records. We will study that stuff in my next tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.